Hello everybody, welcome to my videos. My name's Jamie from MorganJustGames. Today we're doing a product review video. Okay, now this is a combination of an unboxing video as well as a review video. Now, I've been doing my channel for about 4 years. I've not done many reviews, but anyway, I was contacted by FiFine Technology. I hope it's pronounced correctly. FiFine. They asked me, would I like to review one of their latest products, which is a microphone? And of course, I said yes. Microphones are very handy for doing a gaming channel. Okay, so when it comes to microphones, I have to admit it's very up and down for me. The one I had at the start was actually a jack connector, which I use on one of my old laptops. Not much different to this one. Now, I use these sort of microphones if I'm recording a vlog on the camcorder or maybe the unboxing part of an unboxing video. Everything else, I use the PC or laptop, which of course is a USB. This is the one I've been using. This is a Samsung. Now, one of my friends gave this to me quite some time ago, and he said, try it. It's really, really good. You can have it. It's going to be a lot better than the one you were using before. And I kept thinking, this thing is tiny, it's really, really small, it's not going to be up for the challenge. I kept putting it to one side and forgetting about it. But then after a few weeks, I realised the one I was using was horrendous. We'll give it a try. And he so proved me wrong, he really, really did, because this thing is brilliant. I've been using it ever since. It's tiny, fit in your pocket, look. But anyway, been using it ever since, it's superb, it never lets me down. But now it's showing signs of wear and tear. Still works brilliantly, but this bracket here is actually busted. Yeah, it's not great. So anyway, the company contacted me and said, we've got a new microphone we would like you to review. And of course, they gave me the chance, do I or don't I? And of course, I said yes. So they kindly sent me a microphone, which was on Amazon. So thank you for the opportunity to review it. I'll give it a try. It's not going to be a very long video. We'll do a few tests. But anyway, let's get a whirl. Okay, first inspection, really impressed. So many attachments there, a lot more than I was expecting, and the size of the microphone was also bigger than I expected. So yeah, should be really, really good. Now, when I'm doing long plays or streams, for example, yes, this is where I sit, this is where everything happens, but yeah, I don't have a lot of space here. But also, it does come with an attachment, which can be very handy, because then it can actually attach to the side of the table here, and if I'm typing, for example, it's not going to be in my way, where normally it would be. So yeah, it should be really good. But anyway, let's set it up. you go. That was so simple, so easy to follow. It really was. But anyway, in the conservatory is where I filmed it, because it's more spacious. In fact, it's probably the most spacious room I've got in my house. But I don't long play or stream out there. For two reasons. Winter, freeze. Summer, I burn. But yeah, maybe in the future that would change, who knows. But anyway, in the meantime, I recorded out there. Now down here is a lever. You twist the lever, which you can't see. Take it off and place it where you want to go and lock it back in place. But anyway, it twists, it turns, it swivels. Here is a locking mechanism. There's also one here, which you probably can't see. And there's another one there. So many locks, more locks on my front door. So, what I haven't decided yet is when it comes to long player streams, for example, whether I leave it connected here, or maybe put it here, here, or maybe even here. Not sure if I'm going to leave it in shops. Streams make sense, long players probably not. But anyway, we'll set it up on OBS, and I'll show you that as well. Hopefully it's going to be simple to do. And also, never tried one of these before. So we'll try it with and without and see how it performs, and see how it sounds. Okay, this microphone also comes with a cable, which is fantastic. And what is really good about it is it's really, really long, because I'm always fighting with these really short cables. But anyway, it connects underneath there. We'll plug it into the PC and see what happens. Testing 1, 2, 3. Right, so it's actually coming out of the speakers. We've got to change that. Okay, not quite sure how I'm going to record this. But anyway, when I plug it into the PC, it fired up immediately. No installation process. Basically, it's plug and play. It's superb. But just to be sure, I'm sure there's an easier way of doing it than this. But we'll search. We'll go for control panel. We'll go for sound. Double click on that, which brings up more additional settings. We'll go for recording. Scroll down. And we have microphone, USB, PMP, audio device, device default. With a tick next to it, which is superb. Right, we have general settings, listening settings, advanced settings, and level settings. This is your volume control, which is 93, but we can adjust it on here anyway. Right, listen. Okay, so we have our default playback device. So we do a quick test. I'm gonna fire up the sound blasters and put it on maximum volume. Testing 1, 2, 3. Superb. Don't normally do it like that, but anyway, it works superbly well. Anyway, we're going to fire up OBS, we're going to put it on OBS, and I'm sure it's going to be simple, it usually is, and we'll see how it goes. Welcome to OBS. Now, at the moment of time, I'm still using the Samsung Go, because it's already installed on OBS, and I've been using it for absolutely ages. So, we've got to install this bad boy. So as you can see, down the bottom right corner of the screen, the bar is moving with my voice. So yes, if I speak really, really loudly, it's going to go into red. Speak quietly, it'll be in green. But try and set a red if you can. So, when you click on Samsung Go, it gives you settings. Not a lot of settings, but this is where you can select additional settings. Now, as you can see, this has installed immediately. I didn't put it there, it went there itself. But we're going to do this properly. So, we're going to deactivate the Samsung Go. Anyway, you can't hear me now. So, we are going to go to add source. We go to audio input capture. Add source. Then we go to add new source instead. Like so. And we're going to label it as, we'll go for a FiFine mic. There we go. Add source. And then we select it. So we're going to go for the microphone USB PMP audio device. Done. Right, so we should now be using this. So when I tap-a-rooney that, it should work. So it's as simple as that. I don't know how clear it is, but looking at the bottom right, it might need a slight adjustment. Now, does that adjust it to there? I don't think it does. Maybe, I'm not sure. So is that going up and down? Let me know in the comments box below. So, anyway, that was simple. That was really, really simple. So, what we're going to do now, we're going to do a quick few tests. We'll try a few games out and see how it performs with the basic gameplay. Okay, we'll do a few tests. We're going to do 3 different tests on 3 different games, 3 different systems, 3 different settings. So, pick a game at random. We're going to go for Super Mario Bros. 3 on the NES. Okay, so the game is the Super Mario Bros. 3 on the NES Classic. Right, we'll do 3 tests here. So, I'm using the T669 USB microphone, and it is brilliant. It really, really is good, but it's taking some getting used to it. It really, really is. But anyway, three tests. The first one is like this. And I've actually moved the positioning of the microphone to my left. In fact, I've actually changed completely where it was. No longer is it on the coffee table, it's now on the table to my left where my keyboard is and where my old microphone once was. Now, I'm not using a pop filter or pop shield, whatever you want to call it. That is going to be for the second test. Now, the volume should be on the maximum volume. But yeah, it saves me getting used to. But yeah, if you're a podcast channel, then this will absolutely be perfect for you. But for me, it's going to take some getting used to. But anyway, first test, as it sounds. Hope it's not killing the game too much. Course clear, you've got a card. Okay, next game on the list, having a little bit of Rayman. Superb game in copyright 1995 by Ubisoft. Okay, test number two. Now on the PlayStation 1, playing Rayman. Now I've made a few adjustments. The first one is right here. This is the pop filter, which is now in place. And I've never actually used one before. Now you can actually adjust this, same as the volume control. Now this microphone can be used on the Mac as well as Windows. Comes with a pop filter, the microphone with pivot mount and threaded metal ring. Comes with a shock mount, a 2.5 USB cable, a windscreen cap, a C-clamp, a desktop boom arm, as well as a tripod stand, and of course your usual instructions. So a lot in that box. Really, really good value for money. It's superb. I really do recommend it. I've actually moved it back slightly because it was making drinking tea a bit difficult for me because I can basically live on the stuff. I really do. So anyway, it's superb. Cannot fault it. Brilliant. We'll do one more test though. Okay, it is brilliant. It's absolutely superb. But be careful you don't hurt yourself. I've done it twice already. I put all my fingers in there and I did that. And I squashed all my fingers. And the second time, I actually pinched my index finger in there. Again, I put my fingers in places I shouldn't, and I was moving it around. So if you're doing it, keep your fingers clear. But then, if you're putting it in a situation where you don't need to adjust it, you shouldn't have to adjust it, you aren't going to hurt yourself. But anyway, I'm now going to take this off of its stand and go on to the next test. Okay, now this is actually called a windscreen cap. So how does it cope with a little bit of extra additional wind? There you go. I need it, it's boiling in here. Okay, final test, but now on the Amiga, good old Pang, copyright 1989. Right, I'm going to be doing it on very difficult. Right. Okay, final test, now we're on the Amiga. This is Pang, superb game. Now, if you're put off by the desktop boom arm, don't worry, because I kindly included in the box a tripod stand, which is right here. I have to admit, the style of it now is not much different to what one I was using for doing vlog footage. So now it's not so close to me. I'm not using the pop filter though. But also, I am using the fan, which is over there, because this time of year it's absolutely boiling. And on the floor is my PC, which has about three fans of its own. So there's a lot of fans going at the moment of time. But I don't know how well it's picking it up. Hopefully it's not picking up any additional background noise. But anyway, I have to admit, I probably do prefer this. But I will try it out in the future with streams and long plays and see what is best. My problem is I don't have a lot of space. That is always a problem. So yes, where I'm doing this at the moment of time, there's not a lot of room here. So it's always going to be a problem. But who knows what the future may hold. But anyway, if you're looking to get yourself a good microphone for value for money with lots of additional enhancements and possibilities, then this is a good one for you. I highly recommend it. It's superb. Okay, one more change. One more adjustment and we'll put an end to this video. What I've done now is I've actually taken away the windscreen cap, which is here on the table. So now, if there is any additional background noise, it should pick it up, but we'll see. Who knows? But anyway, if you're doing some adjustments with the stand, it's very easy to do. It doesn't take hardly any time at all. It's superb. Just a simple 1, 2, 3, and you're back in business. But yes, do whatever you feel is best for you. I think personally, having no desktop boom arm is probably best for me. But for certain videos, I might try it. But anyway, it's a really good addition, and I want to say a huge thank you once again to the company for sending it and for the opportunity to review your product. It is superb. All the best for the future. I'm sure you do really, really well with this microphone. It is superb. But anyway, I highly recommend it. We'll end it with a boom boom pow. Get additional life. Time is ticking away. There we go. One extra life, 7 lives, and that's the end of my video. Superb. Quiet. You need to aim at you. Put it right like that. Like that, yeah? It's gigantic. I can't even drink my tea like this. I have given my vote. I smashed the like button. Thank you very much. Quality sounds better. Yeah, these mics either
need the gain up or closer to the source of the sound.
Right, okay.
The mic gets good reviews. It's a very good... Yes, I've read the reviews. I've looked at the website. It's very, very good. Very, very good. Just doing my bit for the review. But... Whoa, Jamie! Yeah, avoid the evil ice. Hey, good to see you, Pixel Bit. Hello to Rusty James. You're on holiday. I'm trying my new microphone out. Basically, for my review video I'm working on. How are you doing, Rusty James? Good to see you. How's Daz, by the way? It's a new mic. Yeah, I'm doing a review video at the moment of time. I had planned to do it a lot earlier. But I've been a bit behind. Editing, yes. Recording, yes. So anyway, guys, out of 10, compared to the old one. A lot better, about the same. Let me know. Zero difference. Is it clearer though? Okay. I mean, my old one is falling apart. It really is. It's been held on by white tack. This you heard right. The contraption that holds it together has snapped. How it happened, I don't know. It's the same. Well, as long as it's not worse, so that's a good thing. The old is 7, the 8, it's a very, very minor difference then. Okay. That might be a little bit too far away. I think, anyway. But then that's probably the only place where there's room, I suppose. Everything else is completely full up with stuff.